Well, Iceland has been independent since 1944 when we got our constitution, and that constitution was really almost a translation from one handed to Iceland by the Danish king many decades before. So it wasn't really ours, and the plan has been ever since to revise it and make it a constitution for the people, by the people of Iceland. This has been in the hands of the parliament, but they haven't really managed to revise the constitution in any great detail. So when the financial crash occurred in 2008, there was a great upheaval in our society and people demanded a thorough cleanup. And that involved also the demand for our own constitution. We wanted our constitution, not a translation of a Danish one since 1874. It was decided that this time the public, the people themselves, would have access. And this was done in several steps. One important step was a national gathering of 1,000 randomly picked individuals. The nation is only 300,000, so that was quite a chunk and a representative. And they set the values. They said these are the values that we want to have emphasized in the new constitution. Another important step was that instead of leaving it to the parliament, there was a constitutional council of 25 people elected, and anybody could run for a seat in that. And it was a general election. So these 25 people were elected from 523 candidates. All sorts of people from every walk of life wanted to take part, and of those 25 were elected. And they then were paid full time for 4 months to work on a bill, constitutional bill. They got leave of absence from their ordinary jobs and they concentrated on this task. They had no strings attached. They were not going to be directly affected like the parliamentary members are by the constitution. But here we had people that came, did the work and then left. Okay. For their respective jobs all over society. Now we have to respect the process that is stipulated in the current constitution when we change it. So that means that the parliament has to pass the bill, then there have to be elections, and then the new parliament has to pass it again. Say, for instance, national resources should be the property of the people of Iceland. That is to say, those that are not already in private possession, but they should be rented out for use for a set amount of time and some set amount of money. But you could not sell them, like the right to fish in the ocean, or our hydrothermal power sources and so forth. They cannot be sold, say, to foreign investors who then would export all the profits and leaving the people desolate in Iceland. That is a very strong demand by the people and various others, like human rights and the social welfare system.